So, medyo madali lang yung problem na to. Kasi, yung point A saka point D along the same line na kasi and then walang horizontal forces. So, madaling i-identify kung ano yung maximum tension. But, itong second problem natin, medyo mahirap. Kung i-check mo talaga kung ano yung maximum tension. Kasi, di ba, given yung maximum tension in the cable, which is 40 kN, but hindi natin alam if andyan ba sa A or sa D. Now, at first, you will be tempted na andyan sa A. Kasi malaki yung force na 20 compared sa 10. Following the same, ano tawag dito? Train of thought kanina. But, meron na kasing 15 kN na load which is acting to the left. So, di ba, yung force dito patungo sa left, yung reaction niya ito naman patungo sa right. So yung reaction dito sa D must be 15 plus AX pala. So mas malaki yung horizontal reaction sa point D. But then again, hindi ka pa rin sure if ito yung magi-carry ng mas malaking tension kasi pwede ding ito. So para i-check natin, medyo mahirap talaga yung gagawin dito. But sa book lang, inassume niya agad na nasa point D yung maximum tension. Kasi rigged na kasi yung problem na to. Yan. Pero kung kita yung mag-check, ito yung gagawin natin. For a while lang ah. Open lang tayo ng MathCAD. Yan. So, yan, input muna natin yung problem. And then, let's first try to look at kung saan talaga yung maximum tension. So, ito yung maximum tension, 40 kN. But initially, di ba, isosolve pa natin yung reactions. So, sabihin natin, AY, ito naman, AX. And then we have here DX. Again, acting away from the body yan lahat. And then this is DY. Yan. So, gagawin ko, isosolve ko yung reaction sa AY saka DY. Essentially, yung reaction ng AY is larger than DY. But yung DX, mas malaki kesa sa AX. So, if I will sum up forces along X, I have, diba, AX plus 15, yan yung forces na going to the left, so equal yan sa DX. So, yan. And then, to get AY naman, AY or DY, pwede tayong mag-moment. So, saan ba? Sa A na lang. We can take moments about A. So, we have yan, minus 15 multiplied by YB minus 5. Yan. And then, ano pa? We have 20 multiplied by 7. Plus, since it will cause a clockwise rotation. Itong 15 pala, about A, hawakan natin, apply natin. Yung rotation is clockwise pala. So, plus din to. Yan. And then, plus 10 kN, ito, multiplied by 13 plus 7. So, 20. And then, minus dy, ito, multiplied by 10 plus 13, 23 plus 7, magiging 30. And then, ano pa? We have dx. So, it will cause a counterclockwise rotation about a. So, minus dx pala. Multiplied by a distance of 5 meters. So, set natin yan to 0. But, diba, from this equation, alam natin yung dx is ax plus 15. So, pwede natin yung palitan. Paano ba? Copy ko na lang. Gagawin natin ax plus 15. Yan. So, diba, ra is square root of ax squared plus ay squared. Yan. And then, rd naman is square root of dy squared plus dx squared. Yan. So, how about yung ano naman? Yung reaction sa A along the vertical. Yung masusolve natin dito yung dy, but wala pa tayong ay. So, for ay naman, we can take moments about point D pa rin. So, summation of moments about D, we have negative ax, yan, multiplied by 5, and then plus ay, multiplied by 30, yan. And then, ano pa? Yan, 15. Plus 15, multiplied by yb minus 5. Sa a tayo kanina. Wait lang. Ah, sorry. Ito pala is only yb pala. Going to a, 15 multiplied by yb. Sorry. Hindi ko napansin. Yan. So, yb minus 15, ax, ay, and then we have minus 20, yan, multiplied by 13 plus 10, so 23. And then 10, minus pa rin, minus 10, multiplied by 10. Ito lang ba? Check ko. Ax times 5. Counterclockwise. Counter. Yan. So, set natin to 0. So, gagawin natin, let's input everything sa MathCAD. And then, check natin kung ano talaga yung cable na nag-carry ng maximum tension. Kasi again, if ito yung i-assume mo na 40, mag-iiba na yung sagot. Or kung ito yung 40 mo naman, iba rin yung sagot. So, that's what we have to check. But again, sa book, kung titingnan nyo yung sinend ko na solution manual for the book, automatic kasi in-assume niya na D na yung maximum tension. But hindi pinakita kung paano. Kung paano na determine. So, yan. Page. So, diba, we have our equations para sa dy saka ay. And then, itong yb saka ax, bale, yan yung parang basehan natin sa reaction. So, what we have to do first is input natin yung equation na yan. Ito. So, 15 times yb plus 20 times 7 plus 10 times 20 minus dy times 30 minus ito, ax plus 15 multiplied by 5. So, set to 0. Yan, ito yung first equation natin. And then, the second equation is minus ax times 5 plus ay times 30 plus 15 times yb minus 5 minus 20 multiplied by 23 minus 10 times 10. Yan. So, for the first equation, solve natin yung value ng ay. Ah, wait. Dy pala, dy. Sorry. Yan, we have this equation. And then, for the other one naman, solve natin si ay. So, solve ay. Now, gumagamit lang ako ng MathCAD kasi if we will simplify this, matatagalan na tayo. So, ito na lang. And then, yung important lang kasi is, alam nyo yung process. So, kayo na yung bahala if you want to simplify this talaga by manual methods. So, ito, we can... ito na lang. Retain na lang pala natin. Yan. So, diba, sabihin natin, yung tension at A is equal to square root of, diba, AX squared plus AY squared. Yan. So, ano yung AY? Diba, ito yung value ng AY. So, copy natin. Lagay natin dito. Yan. And then, yung tension naman at D is equal to square root naman ng dx squared plus dy squared. Now, yung dy, it's defined by this expression. So, copy natin. Palitan natin si dy. And then, dx is defined by ax plus 15. So, palitan natin. Yan, ax plus 15. So, as you can notice dito, the only variables na kailangan natin are constants, which are ax saka yb. Now, if we'll check the problem, ano yung minimum value ng ax saka yb? Now, yung yb, by common sense, it must be greater than 5 meters. Diba? Kasi 5 yan, yb is greater than that. So, yung test value pala natin, pwede natin gawing yb is yung minimum lang, kahit yung minimum, lagay natin 5. And then, for dx naman, ano yung minimum value niya? Diba, dx is ax plus 15. So, dx must be greater than 15. So, pwede natin yung gamitin as the minimum value. So, lagay natin AX equals 15. Yan. So, copy daw natin to. Ito yung tension at A. So, press equals. Wait lang. Yan lang pala. So, 25.943. And then, yung tension naman at D is ito. So, press equals. We have 31.273. Now, tension at D is greater pala. Greater than the tensile force at A. So, ito pala yung magde-define ng maximum tension. Hindi yung nasa A. So, bale, at first talaga, parang nasa A kasi 20kN mas malapit sa kanya. But upon checking, doon mo lang malalaman na yung tension sa D is greater than the tensile force at A. So, yung YB, if you if ada natin, let's say, gawin natin 8, this will be lesser. And then, kung gagawin mo yung 100, yan, makikita mo talaga na ito yung mag-govern. Yan, kasi sa first equation kasi for tension at A, negative kasi yung coefficient ng YB. So, parang ima-minus mo siya. So, the greater YB is the lesser the tensile force. Yan. And then, ito naman, if you will increase this, yan, proportional pa rin yan. Gawin natin 70. Yan. Pero, this is, ano na, ang tawag dito, unrealistic value na yan. So, again, sa 15 tayo, ito yung baseline natin. So, mas malaki yung tension dito. Now, since alam na natin na the maximum tension is at D, yung 40kN pala must be acting here. So, ito na yung 40 kilonewtons. Again, mag-iiba yung sagot pag ito yung tinrate mo as 40. So, be careful talaga dyan. So, balik tayo. Now that we have determined ito, kung saan yung 40kN, we can now solve first, masosolve natin yung dy saka dx. And then, since we need three equations, masosolve din natin yung yb. So, yung approach ko dito is saan ako mag-moment para hindi ko magamit si yc. Kasi pag if your equation involves yb and yc, then madadagdagan yung number of unknowns mo. So, kung titingnan natin, if mag-moment tayo sa point A, only yb yung magagamit natin kasi merong 15kN dyan na load. So, hindi masasali si YC. So, pwede tayong mag-moment sa A. And also, pwede din tayong mag-moment sa point B. Yan, kasi di magagamit yung YC kasi walang horizontal force dito. So, yung first equation talaga natin would come from the resultant. So, 40 yung resultant ng dy saka dx. Therefore pala, 40 squared equals, or ano na lang, 40 equals square root of 40 squared plus dx squared. Yan. Medyo mahirap pala i-manipulate. Tanggalin na lang natin na. Gawin natin yung square. So, we can define either, pwede yung dy, i-define natin in terms of dx, or dx in terms of dy. Depende na yan sa'yo. But yung gagawin ko na lang sa discussion na to, is yung dy na lang. Isolate natin si dy, bale, dy squared equals 40 squared minus dx squared. So, to define dy, we can take the square root of both sides. So, yan. Tatanggalin na natin yan. So, ito pala yung value ng dy. 40 squared minus dx squared. And the next, I can take moments about point A. Yan. So, dy times 30. Bale, the same lang dito sa equation na to. So, copy ko na lang. Yan, 15yb plus 20 times 7 plus 10 times 20 and so on. So, this is my first equation. And then, bale, we have this first equation. Ito yung second equation, but we have three unknowns. Dy, dx, saka yb. Di kasi natin alam yan. So, to get another equation involving yb, doon tayo magmumoment sa b. Yan. So, taking moments about b, we have dy multiplied by 10 plus 13, so 23, and then it will cause a counterclockwise rotation. So, minus dy times 23, and then plus dx, this will cause a clockwise rotation about b, and then its moment arm is yb, babawasan natin ng 5. Yan, kasi ito yung moment arm niya. Yung distance na yan. So, yb minus 5. And then, ano pa? We have this force, yan, 10, multiplied by 13 meters going to b. So, plus 10 times 13. Yan. So, we can set this to 0. Yan. Move natin to. For a while lang. Yan. So, now, itong value na to, we can substitute that sa second equation. So, bale, yung dy pala, papalitan natin. Yan. Plug in natin to. Square root of 40 squared minus dx squared. So, magiging 15yb, and then lahat ng constant terms, i-add na lang natin. So, ano yan? 20 times 7 plus 10 times 20. We have 340. So, 15yb plus 340, and then minus dy. Again, dy is square root of 40 squared minus dx squared. Yan. So, kulayan lang din natin. Ito yung dy multiplied by 30. Yan. And then minus dx times 5. So, set to 0. Yan. And so, we can define an expression for yb. Kasi diba, we can move everything sa left right side ng equation and then divide natin by 15. So, simplifying this further, we have yb equals ito na lang yung unahin natin kasi negative yan. Once i-move mo sa right side, magiging positive. So, square root of 40 minus dx squared multiplied by 30. And then, magiging plus din yan. So, plus dx times 5. And then, ito, magiging minus na. So, minus 340. So, divide natin by 15. Yan. So, we have an expression for yb in terms of dx na. So, we can substitute this third equation para ma-solve natin si yb. So, essentially, gagawin ko sa last equation is papalitan ko yung dy din. Yan. Papalitan ko yung dy saka yb. So, mangyayari is negative and then square root of 40 minus 40 squared minus dx squared multiplied by 23. Yan. And then plus dx multiplied by yb, which is this expression. Medyo mahaba. Yan. And then, huwag kalimutan yung minus 5. Yan. So, kulayan lang din natin. So, yan yung yb. And then, plus 10 multiplied by 13. So, set natin to 0. So, masosolve na natin yung value ng dx. Ito lang pala. Yan. So, minus square root of 40 squared minus dx squared multiplied by 23 and then plus dx multiplied by square root of 40 minus x squared times 30 plus dx times 5 minus 340. Divide natin by 15 and then minus 5. Plus 10 times 13, set to 0. So, solving dx, yung guess value natin dapat realistic. So, dx is, diba, ax plus 15. So, it must be a value greater than 15. So, let's say, lalagyan ko ng 18. Yan. Can't solve. Wait lang, minus 40 squared minus dx squared times 23 plus dx double check ko lang. Yan. Plus dx times square root of 40 minus x squared times 30 plus dx times 5 minus 340 over 15 minus 5. But can't solve. For a while, check ko daw dito. Sa kabilang calculator. Times 23 plus dx squared pala yan ah. Ah wait, baka yan yung error. Ah okay, hindi ko na square yung 40. Sorry. Yan. DX is... ba't 14? 4 wala. Bakit 14 yan? Ah, okay. Ano ba yung roots? May tatlong roots to. So, itong 14, yan yung malapit sa gas value natin. But, di ba, makita ko, yan. So, ito yung nasolve natin. Initially. But, realistically, this cannot be the answer kasi, again, yung dx must be greater than 15. So, this is not possible pala. Yan. So, gagawin natin is we have to set a value, guess value na greater than 15. So, pag mag-shift solve ka, lagyan mo na lang ng, para safe ka talaga, lagyan mo ng 100. Yan. So, press equals, 14 pa rin. Middle ground daw. So, shift solve, lagyan natin ng 50. Still 14. Pag ano naman, 40 daw. Wait na, ba't di siya capable? Tatype ko na lang sa mathcad. Ano yung nasa choices? Check natin na. Wala, wala sa choices. Ano daw? 39 daw. Ah, ito. Yan. 39.1947. So, medyo delikado talaga. Kasi, kahit Newton-Raphson, minsan kasi yung calculator talaga, may problema pag marami yung roots. So, ito dapat yung sagot natin. Yan. And then, yung trial value ko para dito is 39 talaga. Dapat malapit talaga. Kasi kung 40, di siya lalabas. Nako. Pag 38 naman, yan, lalabas na siya sa 38. How about 32? Ah, okay na. Lalabas na siya. So, ito yung actual value ng DX. Bakit? This is greater than 15, so this checks out sa assumptions natin. So, dx equals 39.195 kN. So, medyo mahirap talaga yung problem na to. Now, since alam na natin yung dx, masusolve na din natin yung yb. So, yb pala is store ko na lang to, lagay ko sa shift store d. And then, papalitan natin lahat ng dx dyan. So, square root of 40 squared minus dx squared multiplied by 30. And then, plus recall d times 5 minus 340 divided by 15 and then minus 5. So, 1.369 pala yung yb. Ay, but wala palang minus 5, sorry. Ito lang pala. Yan. So, 6.369 pala. Hindi pwede yung 1.36. Bakit? Kasi YB must be greater than 5. So 6 point ano yan? 369 meters. So ito pala 6.37 yung sagot natin. And then yung dy naman, kailangan kasi natin yan, dy equals square root of 40 squared minus dx squared. Yan. So square root of 40 squared minus yung nakastore, recall d, square natin yan, 7.985 pala. Yan. And then kailangan pa natin si YC. So for YC naman, saan ba? Magmumulat na lang tayo sa C, and then let's just use what we obtained sa dy saka dx. Yan. So let me clarify lang. Yung distance na yan is yc minus 5 para sa moment arm ni dx. So summation of moments about c, alam na natin yung dx, 39.195. dy naman is ito, 7.985. So taking moments about c pala, we have minus 7.985 multiplied by 10, and then plus 39.195 multiplied by yc minus 5. Yan, so set to 0, yc pala is ans times 10 plus negative pala, 39.195 times yc minus 5. So 7.037 pala. Yan. So we have letter B pala. Yan. And then for the last question, the total length of the cable, essentially the same lang kanina yung process natin. So we have to first look at this triangle, and then this triangle naman. We can project a line here. Yan. And then finally, we have this triangle. So, gagawin ko is to store ko yung YB sa variable B. So 6.369 shift store B. And then yung YC naman, 7.037, lalagay ko sa C. Yan, so ito yung B, ito yung C. So after which gagawin ko na lang is first, we have this triangle, so yung length niya is square root of 7 squared plus yb squared. Yan, horizontal saka vertical. And then for the second one, yung distance na yan, ito, vertically, this is, diba, yc, yan, bawasan natin ng yb. So yc minus yb pala yan. So square root of yc minus yb squared, and then its horizontal distance naman is 13. And then finally, we have square root of yc minus 5 square natin, and then plus 10 squared. Yan, so the way natin i-input sa calculator, ito na lang. Square root of 7 squared plus yung yb nakastore sa b, so recall b squared, and then plus square root of yc minus yb square natin plus 13 squared, and then plus square root of yc minus 5 square natin, and then plus 10 squared. So we have 32.686, or letter C. Yan. So, essentially talaga, mas mahirap yung cables pag hindi level yung dalawang supports. But madali lang yung analysis kasi parang trusses lang. Medyo mahirap lang to kasi binigay kasi yung maximum tension. So we first have to check kung saan yung maximum tension, whether sa D or sa A siya. So yan.